Hello. In the last video, we have seen the fundamentals of derivatives, what are the derivative products, explanations about the products, forward, futures, options and swaps. We can do little advanced portions of forwards and options trading. So we can go from the slides. So forward contract, the last video we have seen that forward contract and a futures contract. Forward contract is an agreement to buy or sell an asset on a specified date for a specified price. One party assumes long position, you know the long position, we have discussed the long position in the earlier video. And agrees to buy the underlying asset on a specified date and price. And the other party assumes the short position. One party is a long position, he may agree to buy, and the other party in short position, he may agree to sell. That's a contract of forward. The forward contracts having some kind of problem. This is not permitted in stock exchanges, and this has been done in over the counter transactions. So it's a bilateral contract, hence exposed to counterparty risk. Each contract is custom designed and is unique in terms of contract size, expiration date, and asset types and quality. Actually, in forward contract, the contract size is determined by the party. No other organization is able to control the contract size, expiration date, what kind of assets they are, underlying assets chosen, quality. All these aspects are determined by the parties themselves. Contract price is generally not available in public domain. On expiration date, the contract has to be settled by delivery of the asset. The party wishes to reverse the contract, it has to compulsorily go to the same counterparty, which often result in high prices being charged. One party wanted to reverse the contract is very, very tough, and reverse charge may be deposit by the other party. Then useful in hedging and speculation. And it is not standardized. So there are problems with the forward contract, so that the people may choose futures contract. There is limitations. There is no centralization of trading. In futures contract, the centralization of trading is being possible, and it is traded in stock exchanges. And illiquidity. Illiquidity means the counterparty risk. Illiquidity means the you cannot sell. We cannot execute the contract, forward contracts, same like futures and options. And the counterparty risk is another problem. Then futures and option difference, futures traded on an organized exchange, forward over the counter in nature. Futures are standardized, forwards are customized. Customized means the parties can determine the contract size, quantity, whatever it is. And futures are more liquid, forwards less liquid. Futures requires margin payments. Futures for the safety purpose, the last video we have seen, safety purpose, stock exchange keeps margin deposits. If they keep the margin deposit, the transaction will be safe. And forwards, no margin payments. And this is future terminology. Spot price, the price at which assets trade in the spot market. This is spot price. Future price, the price at which futures contract trades in the futures market. The spot price and future price is different. You can search two index in NSE. It's NSE cash market index and futures and option index. Both index are different, so you can understand the spot price and futures price through the index. Spot price index is different from the futures price index. And contract cycle, it's a period of the contract, 1 month contract, 2 months contract, 3 months contract, have been taken place in the exchange, and expiry date, the contract should be some expiry date. It's the last day on which the contract will be traded. This is the future terminology. And the contract size, the load size is determined by the exchange. The amount of asset that has to be delivered under one contract. The load size. Basis, future price minus port price. That's the basis, is a profit earned by the parties. The difference between future price and spot price. And the cost of carry, the relationship between future price and spot price is known as the cost of carry. The profit is determined based on the cost of carry, the time in which the contract length. Initial margin, the margin money deposited by the parties is initial margin. Another one, that is marking to the market. In future market, future contract, the parties need to deposit the premium with the stock exchange. The parties, they may deposit the premium with the broker having their own margin arrangement with the stock exchange. Anyway, the margin is very important, margin is compulsory. So this margin account is adjusted on daily basis. Trading day, each trading day the margin is settled. If one party is in the shortage of margin, that margin would be kept, would be demanded by the broker, and the party should keep that margin. So initial margin and maintenance margin is there. The parties, they wanted to make a future contract, they should keep initial margin. And if the margin, initial margin is shortage, then maintenance margin they should keep. So this marking to the market in the futures contract, at the end of each trading day, the margin account is adjusted to reflect the gain or loss depending on the futures closing price. This is called marking to the market. And the maintenance margin lower than the initial margin, set to ensure that the balance in the margin account never becomes negative. The balance in the margin account falls below the maintenance margin. The investor receives a margin call and is expected to top up the margin account to the initial margin level before trading commences on the next day. So that is the marking to the market and maintenance margin. So now we can go for the option trading. And I can explain the option with the help of an example. So options are like insurance. If we take the insurance, we need to pay insurance premium for getting the insurance. If something risk happened, the insurance company give the compensation. If risk is not happened, it's like a car insurance. If the car accident happens, insurance company gives money for the repairing of car. And if the car car has not come to an accident, then the insurance premium we paid have been taken by the car insurance company. So that for taking this we need to pay the premium. Same way, option is like an insurance, or options is like a lottery. If we want to take lottery, we need to pay lottery ticket fees. And if you win the lottery, we will get claim. Otherwise, the amount spent on the purchase of lottery ticket will be foregone. Okay. So, that's the way we can explain the option. Option consists of two parties. Here, Mr. A and Mr. B. Mr. A have given an option to buy shares of X Limited at rupees 600 each to Mr. B. So Mr. A have given an option to buy shares of X Limited at rupees 600 to Mr. B. So Mr. B, after the expiration of the option, Mr. B can buy some shares from Mr. A at the rate of rupees 600 each. Mr. B buy, Mr. B have purchased right to buy from Mr. A. Okay, the expiry date of the contract will be 3 months.
Mr. B can execute the contract at any time before the expiry of the contract or in the expiry date. So B can execute. The contract is here. Mr. A has given an option to buy shares of X Limited at Rs. 600 each to Mr. B from Mr. A. So after the expiration of the contract, Mr. A should give some shares at rate of 600 rupees to Mr. B. So Mr. B get the right to buy shares from Mr. A. By the time, the share price may increase or decrease. So after the execution of the contract, the share price may increase or decrease. Assume that here, assume that the share price has gone up to Rs. 650. The contract price or the strike price or the exercise price is 600 and the market price has gone up to 650 at the expiration date. So the market price is 650, but here B have agreed, A have agreed to sell some shares to B at the rate of 600, or B has the right to buy from shares at the rate of 600. So market rate is 650. So we must exercise the right, because B will get shares at the rate of 600 rupees from Mr. A. The market price 650. So B will get a profit of 50 per share. So what happened on the back side? A, Mr. A need to purchase shares from the market at the rate of 650 rupees and give to B at the rate of 600. Mr. A has suffering a loss of 50 per share and Mr. B has getting a profit of 50 per share. So what is the position of Mr. A? He may suffer a loss of rupees 50 per share. He need to buy shares in the market at Rs. 650 and should give to Mr. B at rate of 600. Here Mr. A has given a right to B. B can exercise the right or leave it. For getting the right, B needs to pay some amount. A is called option premium. For getting the right, B need to pay some amount to A called option premium. So here in this question, in this example, B have purchased some right from A. For getting the right, here B purchased right to buy shares from A. So right to buy is the right. So for getting for acquiring such right, he need to pay premium. The premium is called option premium. Here Mr. A is called the option writer or option seller. Mr. B is called the option holder or option buyer. The price 600, the contract price is called strike price or exercise price. This option is called call option. Here B purchased the option to buy. So the purchase option to buy is called call option. Then what about the put option? We can go forward and the next slide discuss about the put option. What is the case Mr. A have given the option of right to sell to Mr. B? The last case we have seen the option to buy. Here option to sell. So B has getting a right of option to sell. Means after the execution of the contract, Mr. A should purchase shares from Mr. B, right? The last example we have seen that B purchased the option to buy. So after the execution of the contract, B can buy shares. Here B can sell shares. So A should purchase shares from Mr. B after the contract. Mr. A has given the right to sell shares of X Limited to Mr. B for 600 rupees. Here also 600 rupees. Assume that share price go down to 550. Mr. B must exercise the option because the market price shares go down to 550. Mr. B have a contract agreed with Mr. A and he can sell the shares and he will get a price of 600. At the same time in the market only 550 rupees, but B will get 600. So right now B can get a profit of rupees 50 per share and A will lose rupees 50 per share as loss. So position of A, he may suffer a loss of 50 per share he need to buy shares from B at the rate of 600 and sell it in the market at a loss of rupees 550. So this option is called put option. So two example option. One person as giving option to buy, and one person can give option to sell. A person who purchase option to buy is called call option. A person who purchase option to sell is called put option. So this case we have seen the call option, and for getting the option, the purchaser have to give the premium, option premium, as a reward for getting the option. And the person who sell the option is called option writer or option seller. The person who purchase the option is called option holder or option buyer. And the price in which the contract has been agreed is called exercise price or strike price. So this is the this is the explanation of put option and call option. And this option terminology, there are index option is there, index option and stock option. Index option means the underlying asset is index. Based on the index, based on the underlying assets, the profit or loss may be varied. And European and American option we will discuss in later. And stock options, like in index options, stock options also there. So we can buy put and call options in stock. Stock option also can be European or American options. And the buyer of an option, we have seen the person who buys the right is called the buyer of an option. He need to pay option premium for getting the right to buy or right to sell. And the person who sell the option is called option seller or option writer. It's already seen writer of an option. The writer of a call option, put option is one who receives the option premium and thereby obliged to sell or buy if the buyer exercises. Call option, put option. Call option, the holder the right but not the obligation to buy an asset. Put option, holder the right but not the obligation to sell an asset. So get the right, not obligation. He may or may not take the right. Call option is also right, but it's not obligation, may or may not. If we wanted to take or execute, otherwise the contract may be lapsed. Option price and premium is a reward for getting the right of call option or put option. Expiration date is the contract completed date. Strike price, the price specified in the option contract is known as strike price or exercise price. American options can be exercised at any time up to the expiration date. It's very important. American options can be exercised any time up to the expiration date. European option can be exercised only the expiration date. So European options are easier to analyze than American options.
Here, information with respect to options that will expire after 3 months is available. So the options going to expire within 3 months is available. What kind of options would you opt for? What action would you take on the expiry date? So here, exercise price and expected price on delivery. This is expectation by the client and the actual price on delivery. So with this information, we can find what kind of option would you opt for and what action would you take on the expiry date. Expiry date, you can exercise the option or you can lapse it. Either you can exercise or you can lapse. Two options are available on the expiry. So we can look on the first choice. 180 is exercise price. Expected price is 160. So with this exercise price and the expected price, what will be the client think of regarding options? The current market price is, exercise price of the option is 180 and the expected price on expire is 160. So he expecting the price should decrease. The price will decrease. So, what will be his choice? What option he can purchase? Either put option or call option. Okay, we can look on the answer. The case one, choice, become a put option holder. Okay, why he chooses put option? The exercise price is, option exercise price or strike price is 180, and he believes that the price will come down to 160. His expectation, his emotion, his expectation is 160, the price would decrease, so that he can go for put option. But what happened to actual price on the expiry? The actual price is remains the same with the exercise price, but so that he is not able to exercise the option. What will be required to exercise the option? The price will be greater than 180, then he can exercise, so he can be make benefit out of that. Right now the exercise price and actual prices remains the same, so that the option lapse. And what is the position here? You need to understand the three things: in the money, at the money, and out of the money. So we can go for that. This in the money option, at the money option, and out of the money, three terms are important in options. In the money option. In the money means the client or the purchaser of option is in the position of profit. For the case of call option, the spot price in the market is greater than the strike price or exercise price. That case, the option holder is in the money. Okay. So what the case of put option? This is the case of call option. The put option, the spot price is below the strike price. Put option, the stock price is below the strike price, is called in the money. So spot price is greater than the strike price, is in the money in case of call option. In the case of put option, what will be the answer? Put option, the stock price is below the strike price, or the strike price is greater than the spot price. That way we can say that in the money option. At the money option, that means zero cash flow, that means the spot price is equal to strike price. That position is called at the money. Spot price is equal to strike price. And out of the money is the lowest position by the holder. In case of call option, in case of index and stock, the spot price is less than the strike price. And the put option, the spot price is greater than the strike price. So out of the money option. So here you need to say the position also. The position is at the money, because the strike price is equal to the actual price. Strike price is equal to the spot price. So it's at the money. But the action to be taken is lapse. What the case of choice 2? Exercise price is 125, expected price is 125. So the exercise price and expected price remains the same. So there is no choice, I think. So we can look on the answer. There's no choice. So this is the answer of case second. What about third case? Exercise price 160, expected price 170. Price would increase in the future. So price increase in the future, which option he can prefer? So here he can prefer the call option, because the price will be increasing. So he can get the shares right to buy 160. So he feeling that the price will increase in the later to 175. So he wanted to purchase the shares 160, then he can make a call option. What happened to the price? In the actual price on expiry, the price decreased. That means he cannot exercise the option. His emotions were wrong, his expectation were wrong. He expected that the price would increase, but the price actually would decrease. So that the option lapse. He is in the out of the money. He is in out of the money. So understand all these things. Then intrinsic value of options, call option, put option. Intrinsic value means the difference between the strike price minus the spot price, whatever it. In case call option, the call option intrinsic value means intrinsic value means in the money of options. Three monies, in the money, at the money, out of the money. In the money means the holder is in the profit position. At the money means the strike price is equal to the spot price. And out of the money means it's a negative, the cash flow is negative. And the call option, market price is greater than the exercise price. You can exercise the option. Market price is less than or equal to the strike price. Lapse are not exercise option. Put option, strike price is greater than the market price. You can exercise the option. And strike price is less than or equal to the market price. Lapse not exercise option. This is intrinsic value of the option. So the derivatives can be both stock derivatives and index derivatives. Here index derivatives, index futures and options are also there. Then we can look on the payoff of options. Here it is index option. We are discussing the index option. Nifty's position is 2220 and sell it at a future date at unknown price. Once purchase, investor is said to be long the asset, unlimited profit and limited loss. So we can look on this slide. This is slide payoff of buyer of call option. Payoff for the buyer of call option. A call option gives the buyer the right to buy the underlying assets, such as strike price specified in the option. Profit or loss that the buyer makes the option depends on the spot price of the underlying. The spot price exceeds the strike price, one makes a profit. Here the spot price is more is a profit. Here if the spot price of the underlying is less than the strike price, one lets option expire and thus exercise. Loss is a premium he paid for buying the option. So the buyer of the call option, and he paid premium 86 rupees 60 paise. And his strike price is 2250 and he makes profit out of the prices increases to the level. Whatever it is profit. And if the price decreases 2250, the loss would be the result. Then writer of call option, same example. Option seller get 86.604 as a reward for selling of option, call option, and this is his return 86.60 and 2250 from the prior point onwards. The price, he expecting the price fall, but his income is limited to 86.60. He will not get any amount. The only thing he will get is the price increased, he may suffer the losses. 2250, 2300, 2400, that cases he may suffer losses. Then the buyer of put option. Put option gives the buyer the right to sell the underlying asset, the strike price specified in the option. Profit or loss buyer makes on the option depends on the spot price of underlying. Upon expiration, the spot price is below the strike price, one makes profit. Lower the spot price, more is a profit. If the spot price in the underlying is higher than the strike price, let the option unexpired and SSX. Loss is a premium he paid for buying the option. It's put option buyer. Put option buyer, you know, he is purchasing the right to sell. And 250 right to sell. And the share price would decrease 2250. From the point onwards, the share price need to decrease to get the profit. You already spent 61.70 as premium. And if the share price decreases from this 2250, he may get the profit. Okay, this is the position of a put option buyer. And this is the case of put option seller. 2250 the strike price. 61.70 he get get as premium, and he may suffer the losses if the 2250 the price decrease from this point, he may suffer the losses. So this is a payoff graph, and actually 56 is the strike price, and he paid, the option holder paid premium 8 rupees. This is a case of call option, and paid 8 rupees, and 56 is the strike price. So at least he should 64 is a break even point, because 56 plus 8, 64. 8 rupees already spent as premium. So 64 is a break even point in the case of this call option. If the price moves up from this 64, whatever it is, the profit of profit to the call option holder. So with this topic, I end this option payoff, and I will come up with the next option pricing in the next video. Thank you.